So you just recently had a meeting with 21 UN agencies. That is a lot of agencies working together. Did they initiate the meeting, or it's from BMA?
Yeah, I think BMA and UN has been working together for a while, right? And then we have a visit from Her Excellency Geeta, who is a resident coordinator of UN. And then she kindly invite us to meet with the head of the 21 organization. It's very exciting, I think, because all of them are the experts in their area, right? We've met many WHO, IRO, so many experts in the field that really understand the problem, the local problem.
What was your expectation walking into to the meeting?
Yeah, I think we feel honored, and then I think because I feel that our problems are not original, you know.
Right.
The problem happens somewhere else in the world, and sometimes we don't have to find the solution by ourselves. I mean, we can learn from others, and I think UN is an excellent organization because they work in many countries, so they learn from other countries' problems, and they have solutions that many of them have been proved, you know. They also understand our problem because I think they have their base in Thailand. So they empathize with our problem too.
And they experience it themselves.
Yeah.
We were notified that the topic will involve the environment, waste management, and urban digitization. Was that the focus of the meeting, or there's anything beyond that?
Yeah, I think we start with our vision, right? Our vision is that the vision of our team, we want Bangkok to be a livable city for all.
Right.
So with this, we come up with a 9 guiding policy, like good mobility, health, safety, management. And with these 9 guiding policy, we have like 216 action plans,
right.
Which, I mean, all these touch every of the 21 organizations.
With your opinion, you start working as a governor already. What is the most pressing issue, you think, or most concerning?
I think at the beginning would be transparency.
Okay.
Of Bangkok. I think without transparency, we cannot get the trust from the people.
Mm.
So I think we have to start with transparency, which I think UN can get involved with this. You know,
like, how would they help, though, with transparency?
I think if you look at FDG, I think transparency is a key thing. If you want to have a sustainable development goal, you need transparency. When we can create trust among people, now we can go to other problems like environment, garbage handling, even inequalities.
Mm.
I think many of the UN units work on this type, you know, education, right? So even culture. I think working with UN is like standing on the shoulder of the giants, you know. I mean,
because they are so big and
they have
international.
Yeah, and they have experience, information, right? I mean, so if we can learn from them. And with our experience, maybe we can see maybe further than them by standing on the shoulder.
Those 200 and something action plan, you have 4 years. Do you think you're going to complete all of those?
Maybe
in
not
4 years?
All of them, but I think we will initiate all of them.
Right.
But maybe some of them will be canceled because when we come in, it might not be suitable.
Mm.
As you mentioned, we look from the outside. Right? So, but we have to tell why we don't do this and why we increase more plans, you know. So everything is on the website. So I think we need open policy that people can see and then they can expect what is the progress now. So all this will increase transparency, which I mentioned will be the first problem of Bangkok. Yeah.
What is the biggest challenge as the Bangkok governor of year 2022?
Drive people. You have to drive to get the result, right? Because we are not the one. We have to unify all the BMA officials together and develop the proper strategy and not, when I say commanding trust from people, not only from the Bangkok people, but from our staff that we can lead them and make them work together for the people. I told them just focus on the people. I mean, I think previously many of them looked to the governor for the order, right?
Because you are their boss.
Yeah, but I think you should look at the people, right?
Right.
And the people are the boss.
Uh-huh.
I'm the one who pushed them, like providing backup for them to serve the people.
What would be an indication for you to see that things are moving into the right direction already?
I think we need like all the 216 projects, we have like KPI, you know, how progress we are. And so maybe the simple thing, as I said, we want the Bangkok to be a livable city for all, right? So like livability index would be one single indicator that see some, if we see some improvement, right? Right now we are 98 from 140. Okay. Yeah, but for, bottom line, look at the people. They are happy or not. If they feel happy, I think we are going in the right direction because the city is the people, right? It's not like infrastructure. So if the people feel that we are going to the right direction, I think maybe we are doing the right thing.